All right, so problems with Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac lit the financial fire, sparking this economic meltdown that we've seen. But the problem, of course, was years in the making. And there were some early warning signs that came in 2003. So the big question, how did we get into this mess? And what will it take to save the U.S. financial system? In the most comprehensive look at this I've seen, Chief Washington correspondent Jim Angle joins us from D.C. Jim?
Hello, Martha. Well, yeah, you know, the problem with Fannie and Freddie is, look, that they do not actually make mortgage loans. They buy mortgage loans from firms that do make those loans. And whatever Fannie and Freddie are willing to buy, that is the kind of mortgage you are likely to get. Now, way back in the early years, just after 2000, 2001, 2002, 2003, there were a lot of warning signs, and you had people in the administration and the Federal Reserve warning that Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac were getting too big. These are government-sponsored enterprises, sort of quasi-governmental, and the idea was, of course, that they had some government backing. People were worried they were getting too big. In fact, Alan Greenspan from the Fed actually said that we put at risk our ability to preserve safe and sound financial markets if we don't worry about the size of these two organizations. Efforts to do that and to give them stronger oversight were blocked by Democrats in Congress because they thought it would prevent Fannie and Freddie from extending loans to poor people. The whole idea here was that they wanted more, quote unquote, affordable housing. So affordable housing means getting housing and mortgages to people who couldn't otherwise afford them. That is what was done with those very low teaser rates on adjustable rate mortgages. And as we now know, since housing prices did not continue to go up, when the teaser rates disappeared and they went up to higher rates, a lot of people couldn't pay, a lot of mortgages failed, and we now have this huge mess with all of these mortgages that were sliced and diced and sold throughout the financial markets, not just in the U.S., but around the world. And now everybody is trying to figure out where the problems are and how to get rid of them. And that is what this entire debate is about, Martha, how to go in and buy all that stuff and get it out of the hands of all the financial firms who can't borrow money or loan money because no one knows how much they're exposed.
Martha. You know, there's a lot of Democrats pointing the finger at Republicans saying, you know, you allowed for this environment where there were no regulations, because typically Republicans like to see less regulation because they want the markets to sort of work on their own. They don't want the government interfering. Is that a fair criticism on the part of Democrats that Republicans did not allow regulation that might have been necessary?
Well, it is generally true that Republicans don't like as much regulation, but in the case of Fannie and Freddie, that is not the case. In 2005, the Senate Banking Committee, then under Republican control, actually passed out legislation that would have increased the oversight of Fannie and Freddie because of the problems that Alan Greenspan and others were mentioning that they were getting out of control. That passed on a party line vote out of the committee, all Republicans voting for it, all Democrats voting against it, and it never got to the floor of the Senate because, of course, you have to have 60 votes to pass anything, and they didn't have 60 votes, so it never came up for a vote.
Yeah.
So in the case of Fannie and Freddie, Republicans tried to impose much stricter regulation, but were unsuccessful because Democrats blocked them, in part because they didn't want to slow down any effort to extend loans to those who were having difficulty getting mortgage loans. And as it turns out, we know why, because many of those people couldn't afford them.
All right. Great explanation, Jim, as always. Thank you very much, Jim Angle, joining us from Washington.
You know, and as we